Hello everyone, it's Connie Ray. Welcome to stampityourself.com. I have a new tutorial today, and that is going to be a window box using the window box thinlet dies. I'm making this little box here, and I'm also using out of the annual catalogue the designer series paper that is actually, when you look at it, it is white, just like this. As you can see, there's some shiny. This is a straight up and down design. So there's some shiny design on it, but you can add color to it anytime you like. Bear with me. I'm just going to bring you into focus again. Basically, we're using that. And that is going, it's called the actual Irresistibly Floral Specialty Designer Series paper. And it's in the annual catalog. And you get 12 sheets of 12 by 12. I have used this particular, this is my favorite design. Out of the paper that we've got, there's other designs as well, but this is my most favorite. I love the flourishes and I love coloring it in. It's just absolutely gorgeous. And this little box is a great little box for a gift or chocolates or whatever you desire. On the inside, when you open it, because I put a little shaker window in there and you want to hide that shaker window so that nobody sees it, on the inside we put a little hearts underneath, and also the little sentiment love you and some more of the designer series paper. So I have done this probably 100 times and I'm running out of my favorite paper, so bear with me while I struggle through this video, because I haven't done a video for a while, so I'm all fingers and thumbs, as they say. Okay, this box here was one of my drafts, and this was done in the rose red colour of Stampin' Up's colours. And that colour is, again, it's a nice Valentine's colour, I should say. But you can do this in any colour you like, and it always turns out beautiful. I've done this box, which was my second attempt, I think, or third attempt, maybe fifth. And I've done this in Worn Lipstick. And this is Distress Ink, and it's Worn Lipstick by Ranger Tim Holtz. That I found actually is very smooth in colour to use, and I enjoyed using it just a little bit differently to the Stampin' Up one, but I like both of them, so I've done it before. And there was a previous tutorial that I did do, and I used this same paper, and I used Indigo Island, and it was a box that I did, and I did it all on that beautiful blue Indigo Island. So all of them will work. You just need to have your blending tool, and you need to have your ink of choice. Now, I've used the Window Box Thinlet dies, and I've also used the second biggest circle out of the stitch dies. I've used two love hearts, and you need to put these love hearts together, and you need to put them in a position like this, and you need to put some masking tape on them. And when you're running them through the Big Shot, just popping it down like that, popping it onto the Big Shot, so that you're cutting out a piece that looks like this, and you're also cutting out a heart at the same time. And I'll show you exactly why you need to do it like that. So you need to do that first. Well, you don't need to do that first, but that's one. Get all the cutting out of the way, I must say. It is a little bit easier once you've done that. Now, for this piece here, I have cut out some, what have I cut out? I have cut out around, where's my piece gone now? I've lost it. Oh, here we go. Okay, I have cut out the piece that's going to go into the back of, well, the top box, the top of the lid, and it's going to cover your workings of your shaker component of your box. So you need to do a circle of that. I've also used this to cut out two pieces of window sheet to create my shaker card. So I've made the shaker card, and the reason I'm actually at this stage is because this is the second time I've tried to record this, because I had a few issues putting the box together. Huh, funny that. So anyway, I've got some window sheet or some acetate, whatever you want to use. I haven't bulked it up. I've just put one layer on top of the other with the shaker component inside. This is the colour that I'm actually using for the box, and I've used this colour for two reasons. Is number one, it actually stands out when I've coloured it so that you can see it. And secondly, it is gorgeous. It's just a lovely colour. And this is Seedless Preserves Distress Ink from Tim Holtz. And I have blended that all the way around on this using that So this is the color of the box that we are making today. All the other ones are just drafts. Okay, so I had all previously recorded this and I've recorded myself coloring it in. And of course, I made an error putting the box together. I think I glued it upside down or something like that, which does not surprise me because I do that kind of thing. Anyway, so let me go back to the original component that we were looking at before I go any further. So you need two pieces of window sheet. You need to cut the heart out before you start colouring or after you've coloured your sheet. If you do it 6 by 6, because you get when you're using the die, you have to cut out two pieces of this die of this paper. So in this component here is where your heart's going to be in the middle. So you cut your heart out using the die. And that's going to be the shaker component there, like I have done there. You get the two pieces of window sheet. As I said, I didn't bulk it up. What I did is I just used some double-sided tape, put my shaker card components in, and stuck it down flat. Keeping in mind that you don't want to see any of the makings of the card behind here. You don't want to see any glue. Let me see if I can bring that up for you and show you a bit better. You don't want to see the glue. And you don't want to see any components coming through here. So just be mindful of the heart. Okay, now the next part that I will show you is the effect that you get when you do colour it in. So this is another design. It's not the design that I've this paper. It's out of the same paper. It's out of the same stack that you get when you purchase the designer series paper. But this is my all-time, this is my favorite one, this one. And I've used it all. So I'd have to order some more. But in the meantime, I thought since I made a mistake in my first recording, I just can still show you exactly what it's like when you color it up. So it's all white. Doesn't matter which pattern you choose, whatever you prefer. And you're just going to blend on your color. And it comes up beautifully just by using your blending tool and the color of ink of choice. So just working around blending it once you've cut it out or before you cut it out. It will be like this. It will be a 6 by 6. So when I've cut my heart out of here. So it is a 6 by 6 that you actually need for this die to actually fit into. So it will work and it comes up beautifully. This is also another lovely one, but the flowers are my favorite. These ones are flowers, but they're different kinds. They're more like the succulent range that they've got going at the moment. And this does go with them very well. So that's the paper and the way that you can apply paper. Sorry, the color to the paper and how it changes. Once you've got it all inked up, and you can make it as light or as heavy as you choose. You can use different colors. This one here, I ex was experimenting and I used crushed curry and rose red. I tried there and I tried blending them in, and they look good like that too. As you can see, I used all my favorite pattern again and I used it all up. Oh, I'm heartbroken. I have to order some more. So, anyway, that's how you're blending. And here's another one with the rose red. It still looks good. It's and the only reason I'm sort of saying it still looks good is because that this pattern is my favorite. I love it. Anyway, moving right along. So we've gotten to the stage where the heart's been put in. You've cut out your using your circle, and the only reason I use that is because it goes over just nicely and it's neat and it can be covered up. So then you've cut out your heart pieces. Again, I have colored the little heart, this white heart that came out, and this piece with the same color that I've used on the box, which is here. And then I have basically stuck this down right over the top and quite evenly. Now, this is the top of the box. So when you open up the box, you're going to, I've done it two-tone deliberately because I wanted to, when I put my sentiment on, it's got that two-toned kind of halfway down look. And I liked it like that. So I've done it halfway down. Now, I just need to put a little bit more tape on here to stick this down. And look, making sure that it's cosmetically sound And by that I mean that when you put it over the top of your shaker card, you're not going to see any of the tape through the window. It's going to be pretty hard to spot, to be honest, because you've got your shaker component there. You've got all this the blingy bits. So no one's really going to notice it. But it's nice to know that when you do something, it's done properly. And a little bit more. And this idea came because I just wanted to hide the cosmetics to make it more cosmetically appealing when you open the box, that it doesn't look you can't see the makings of it. My tape won't cooperate now. Oh, Murphy's Law, isn't it? You start to do something and you think you've got it all worked out. You start recording it. If anything's going to go wrong, it's going to happen when you're recording. I run out of my favorite paper. I've had to do this. I think this video I've actually done 3 times now. So, not to worry. We're getting there. All right. So this is the part that opens up. So we want our heart just to go. I'm going to turn this around, but basically I'm going to put this on top here. But I want to make sure that the heart is actually in position. So you're just going to turn it over. Now you will be able to see it, but you'll be able to see it in the sense where it's not going to be. I have to shake it and have a look at it and bring it up close so that I can see what I'm doing. But basically, you're just going to cover up the back of it with the little heart that's stuck on here and your cosmetic covering. And to be honest, if you put it down pretty well, much the same as, I think this is the best way to do it because you can see it. So if you just line up one side of it up the top, just lining it up as we go, I'm pretty sure you'll be right. There we go. Done. All right. Give it a quick squeeze down. That should be good. All right. So you can see the little hearts. Sorry, the heart. And then I've got little stars in there that I've used for the shaker component. So it looks really good. All right. And then I've gone ahead and I've started to, and this is where I went wrong before. I started to put the box together and I stuck it upside down. So you can imagine my surprise while filming when I went to turn it around and pull it together this way. It kind of was, I had two lids. It was like, oh my gosh. Okay, so that I don't do that again, I am going to redo it. Practice on some white spare cardstock. Practice before you get to the part where you, not like me, don't use all your good stuff first. Practice a bit before you get into it when it comes to putting this box together, just so you you're not making the mistakes that I made. It's not hard to put together, but you do have to focus if you're anything like me and you have no sense of direction. Oh my gosh. Okay, that goes down like that. Yep. On there. This is a gorgeous little box, this one. It comes up so beautifully and you get a lot of components in with the actual die itself, so there's a lot more to play with later on as well. Just making sure now that I haven't got the box backwards or something crazy like that. Goodness me. Okay. So you're just basically going left, right, I suppose, is one way of looking at it. And then you're sticking it down. Whoop, missed one here. And it depends what you put in here too. You don't need a lot of tape. It grabs pretty well. You've just got to get it off. Okay. Actually, if you do it like that, it does line up really well when you're going left to right, left to right, if that's for want of a better word, but that's basically the easiest way to put it together. Okay, and one more piece, which is this piece here, and this one just folds straight on, the flap goes over and joins up with the opposite flap, but it's folded over per se, and then it's joined up in the middle. And you can see that the box is actually, oh, not quite straight, but it's a little bit tricky, but it's not too tricky. And wouldn't it be funny if I actually was putting it together completely wrong again? There we go. Okay, so guess what? It's together. Okay, so as you can see, it's kind of really looking a little bit better. Okay, so that is the box itself, all ready to go and to gift to somebody. I've got stars everywhere. Okay, so this, did I say, I'm not quite sure if I actually, yes, I did. I said it was done in Sealer's Preserves, which is the ink that I have used to blend it all in. I'm confused which video I'm up to now. So anyway, that's the box there. Now we are just going to put in a couple of little pre-made sentiments. This one is using the white embossing powder, taking out a dimensional, just cutting it up. White embossing powder, and we're using the Versamark ink. Sticking it down. And I liked the two-tone kind of shade on the Love You when you open the box. It was lovely, I think, when you open it up, it's got that there. But then I also wanted to put something here. Now, I'm missing, here we go. Now, this little piece here, I did on my other box, stick that over the top because it just looks a little bit nicer. So I'm just going to glue that down just with some Tombow glue, making sure I haven't got too much on there. Just over the top of the heart, it just gives it a little bit more of a finish. Just looks more finished off like that. And then last but not least, I have got the embellishment to go onto the bottom of the box because I felt that it needed a work. I mean, it doesn't, but it does. It's entirely optional if somebody wants to put that on, or if you don't want to put that on, you don't have to. I just felt it looked a little bit better with something on it. It's just a preference, I suppose. But it does look kind of cute with the sentiment on there. Is everything going to not work today? Now I've got dimensionals sticking to my fingers that don't want to go anywhere. Murphy's Law, always. Nearly done. So I hope this video has made more sense to you than it is to me right now. Popping it under the heart. Yes, I do hope that it's making more sense to you than it is to me. I've got little stars everywhere in the bottom of the box. But anyway, look, that is the design for today. That is the tutorial for today. I hope you have enjoyed it. I hope it hasn't been too confusing. But it is really, really pretty, a lot easier than I have probably made it. You've got this gorgeous paper that you can turn into any color you want, which I just love that idea. I just think that that's fantastic. I just love the idea of, I mean, there's a coloring in paper that we have where you can get your colored pencils and you can color in the images and stuff like that. Oh, I had a little heart somewhere here. Oh, here it is. And that's different to this paper. This paper is purely white. And it is, I'm just going to get a glue dot now and turn it into a little donut. Just roll it with my fingers and pop it under this little heart that I've got here that I've cut out of foam. And I'm just going to pop this little heart right here. There we go. So those are the two boxes that I have made. Okay, using the, as I have suggested, the Windows box thinlets dies. I have, for the sentiments, I have used Amazing You, and this is out of an old Express Yourself hostess set. I don't know if it's still available. I'm pretty sure it's probably not, but look, you can use anything on these. These are just boxes that you can use for Easter, for items to give to somebody. It's entirely up to you. When you open the box, you've got Love You stuck inside, and I have used the Blooming Love, which is in the annual catalogue, I do believe. And again, I have used the Irresistibly Floral Specialty Designer Series paper. You get 12 by 12 sheets, and you get 12 of them, and they come and they are just white, just like that. And you add the color yourself with a blender brush, coloring in the color of your choice. That is the, no, this is rose red. This one here is the distress ink that I have used for this box. So have a play, have a muck around. It's a really lot of fun, and I think it makes really an easy box to make. This is the rose red. I haven't finished, but this was my template for the rose red as well. So using those three, you've got a choice of color. You can use any color. And of course, previously in another tutorial, I did make some boxes that are done in the indigo blue, sorry, island indigo, and they were boxes that I made, and that was the first time I'd ever used it, and I just fell in love with it, particularly this design. And I'm run out now, and I haven't got enough to go over it. Well, the other thing I've done is I've just put a few sequins on the top here to make it look pretty. You can add them or leave it off. It's entirely up to you. But that's the tutorial. So thank you for joining me. I appreciate you stopping by, and I hope to see you soon with a new tutorial. And please subscribe, and if you need any of the products, you can just go up to the header on this page and go in and buy these products straight off the website, or go to my blog, which is stampityourself.com. So thank you for joining me, and thank you for your patience, and I hope to see you soon with a new tutorial. Ciao for now.